can't talk about anything without being affected by our arm. If you're beginning at the bow and you pick up the bass and you bow and you start bowing, the tendency is to lock your arm. And of course that will make the bow what I call travel on the strings. That sound, kind of fun sometimes for avant-garde stuff, but generally trying to get a good sound, it's not what you want. So if you pay attention to drawing the bow straight, or if you hold the bass straight up, some people say draw it parallel to the floor. Now, with the fingers, I change how much hair I use, which I'm maybe jumping ahead to one of the other things, but someone commented on how much hair. It does affect your sound, what you want. You want the hair loose enough that if you choose to have only part of the hair, you can do that. And if you want all the hair with the angle of the bow, you can glue that attack. But now I'm not. And changing it, and I'm moving it to get different sounds, you know. Increased speed and pressure obviously affects the dynamics. That was a little bit of increase in pressure and speed.
Excuse me.
Yes, I love pressure.
Do you use actually muscular pressure? How much is arm weight?
It's some of both. When we are here on the bass, you have much more natural arm weight. But if I kept that weight the same as I draw, then my bow is going to go here. So as I move toward the tip of the bow, part of what I was talking about with moving your hand and your wrist creates more pressure against the tip. So I was mentioning earlier this ability to do this with the bow. That's where that comes into play.